The parents of a victim of a school shooting meet face to face with the parents of the perpetrator. Welcome, movie watchers. Thank you guys for stopping by my channel. Today we're going to be talking about Mass. Mass had its premiere at Sundance earlier this year and is finally making its way into theaters this October. This film stars Reed, Bernie, Ann Dodd, Jason Isaac, and Martha Plimpton. This film takes place in one setting where the parents of a victim of a school shooter that are meeting the parents of the perpetrator for the first time. They're just discussing everything that happened, emotions. This is a time for them to share their grief, stories, whatever it may be. This is probably one of the most emotional films I have seen this year. This is a film that requires a lot from the audience. At times, the people don't even get up out of their seat for a good majority of the movie. And it's just focused on this conversation. But what makes this film so emotionally rewarding at the end of it is that it's so raw. It just feels so real. Like four parents are actually getting together to discuss what had happened. The parents of the perpetrator discussing their son's upbringing. The parents of the victim discussing everything about their son. There's so much emotion within this room and the performances are amazing. Jason Isaacs gives a really heartbreaking performance. There's a couple scenes where he lets his emotions just take over the conversation and we're watching the other three parents just react to it all. And this film doesn't hold back on discussing what had happened at the school. There's no flashbacks within the movie. We are already past everything. The parents are dealing with their grief and the loss of their child. And they're just having this conversation. So you're jumping into the middle of this all. And at times, really early on in the film, they aren't even giving you full details about the school shooting and their sons. Just going into it like these characters are. They already know what had happened. And they are awkwardly starting the conversation. And then once we dig a little deeper into the movie, then you start to learn about what actually had happened and learning more about their children as well. The way that this film was set up in the beginning, a couple of the church members were setting up the room for the four parents to come in. And you got the sense really early on in this movie that it was going to be something emotional because they kind of tiptoed around what the conversation was actually going to be about and the people that were going to come to the church to have this conversation. Once all the characters sit down, it's awkward. And I totally expected it to be that way. And that just gives it that sense of realism to the movie. They bring flowers and they don't know where to put the flowers, the tissue boxes. They just kind of awkwardly walk around, ask how was the drive in. Easy conversations because they just don't know where to start with the conversations. But as the movie progresses, and this is almost 2 hours long, and you just listen to them for talk for almost 2 hours, the real emotions start to come out, and you're just absolutely glued to the screen. But there's times where it's just a lot, and at times it just feels like a lot, that you just need to like take a step back from the conversation. Because it's like constantly going. Some of the things are really hard to hear, but this is a thing that happens to people. And it's unfortunate that school shootings are an actual thing. It's just terrible. You know, as a teacher myself, it's just, it's always like in the back of my head that, you know, something may happen one day. But listening to these parents and how they handle their grief and how they want to not move on, but accept things as well and forgive people. You realize that there are parents out there that are grieving, and it makes it just so hard to watch this because it is a very touchy subject and something that happens plenty of times a year. And watching these parents, it just feels so real. It just feels so raw. And the performances, the minimal directing, camera movement, it just makes it just so tense when you're listening to these four parents. And Fran Kranz is the director of this film. This is his first directed movie. I loved the minimal directing efforts, the camera movement, because you're really able to just focus on the conversation. This room is pretty bare too. There's not really much in it. So there's like really not anything that will distract you from this conversation. So the slow pan around the room, the camera is sitting still on the characters. You're just really able to get invested into the conversation and let the emotions just really flow throughout the film. In the film, Jason Isaacs is married to Martha Plimpton's character. I remember Martha Plimpton from The Goonies. She was one of the characters in there. But in the film, Jason Isaacs and Martha Plimpton are the parents of the victim of the school shooter. They want to know what happened with the son of the other family. And did they notice things throughout the years that could have led to this or could have been prevented? They have a lot of questions that they want to be answered. And you could tell that the other family is a little bit nervous of having these conversations because their son is the one that killed Jason Isaacs and Martha Plimpton's son. So there's a lot of tension just immediately when they meet each other. And they've seen each other on television and read each other's statements and stuff. But you could tell that it easily could have gone the wrong way. And it could have been to where they were angry with each other and maybe they would have fought. But it was just a chance for them to express their emotions, get answers to their questions. It's all done in a realistic way. Not one second of this movie did I think it was fake or it was staged. I didn't think for a second that this movie felt so scripted. It just flowed so nicely, and the conversations and the performances just felt so real to where you just felt like you were watching actual parents discuss the school shooting. And the performances are some of the best that I've seen this year. Mass is a movie that is truly emotional. It is a tearjerker just because of the conversations and how the parents are expressing their emotions within this movie. It's directed so well, and having it be in one setting allows for you to just really listen to the conversations and not get distracted by anything. So before I give you my score for Mass, make sure to check out my channel. Here I do movie reviews, trailer actions, ranking videos, tier lists, all that fun movie related content you see on YouTube. I do it all here, so hit that subscribe button to get it all in one spot. I'm gonna go ahead and give Mass an A-. Thank you guys for checking my review for Mass. Make sure to check it out in theaters once it does hit. It'll be in select theaters, but make sure to check it out because it is worth your time. My name is Justin Watches Movies, and you guys stay classy, YouTube.